Hey everyone, okay, so today we're going to be talking about the big fat setting spray lie and why it just doesn't work for some people, myself included, a lot of the time. So let's just jump straight in. So what is a setting spray? So basically, a setting spray is used to set your makeup and to prolong the life of your beautifully created art piece that you've just meticulously designed yourself. Now, what can setting sprays actually do? Well, setting sprays can prolong makeup. They absolutely can. They can also help prevent makeup from moving and transferring, which is a real biggie. And they act as an invisible shield to prevent the makeup from fading and just generally the longevity of your makeup. That's what they're really for. So what is actually in a setting spray that allows this alchemy to come about? Now, usually they contain polymers, which are often, but not always, but often dissolved in a solvent, which is basically alcohol. Most, but not all, setting sprays will have some form of alcohol. Now, once they're sprayed all over the face, the solvents dissolve or evaporate, and they leave behind the polymer, which basically holds your makeup in place all day long, allegedly. Now, some of these setting sprays can also add waterproofing, which is amazing, because some people really do want a waterproof effect. So here's a little fun fact for you. The more solvent, or i.e. alcohol, that the product contains, the more chance it actually has of dissolving the makeup. Yes, you heard that right. They can actually dissolve makeup. Have you ever wondered why, when you're using a setting spray on yourself, that after you sprayed your face, your makeup looks better than it did before? Yeah, that's because it's dissolving some of the makeup. Also, have you ever seen those YouTube videos where they put on an absolute bugger load of makeup and it's heavy and cakey, and then they spray it with setting spray and it's dewy and wearable and gorgeous? Well, yeah, that's because it's dissolved some of the makeup. You can test this yourself. Just spray tons and tons of setting spray over your made-up face and you can literally watch it dissolve. It's fun, eh? So the polymers that are used in these setting sprays are very close, and some are identical to those basically used in hairsprays. Yes, you could use hairspray to set your makeup, and yes, it does work, but the ingredients in setting sprays are much more friendly to the skin, so I wouldn't really recommend it. I really, really wouldn't. Now, not all setting sprays are created equal, but they're all called setting sprays. Some, as mentioned above, will actually hold the makeup in place and set the makeup, while others will just remove that kind of powder residue. A good example would be Skindinavia, HUDA, Charlotte Tilbury, Urban Decay All Nighter. Those will set and hold your makeup, while something like MAC Fix Plus, that just gets rid of the powder residue. Okay, so you ready for the big fat lie? Well, here it is. If setting sprays are so good, then why do they fail so many people? And that's something that I think is quite hard to understand and hard to benefit from, because when you're reviewing these products, people will say, my makeup lasted all day long, it's amazing, while other people become a shiny mess after an hour or so. The reason? Oily skin. Most people that will benefit from a setting spray tend to have normal combination to dry skin types. Oily skin types are gonna have a problem. Now, we've all seen the demonstrations of people applying eyeshadow to their arm, then they spray setting spray and rub it vigorously. And of course, I myself have done those same demonstrations. But when was the last time that your forearm produced huge amounts of oil? It's hardly the same as it is with your face, right? Because your face is constantly pumping out oil, particularly if you're an oily skin type. Now, setting sprays will not prevent your skin from producing oil, and that's the problem. The oil will break down any setting spray. Granted, your makeup will last longer with a setting spray. It absolutely will, but it won't prevent the breakdown of it and the smearing and the oiliness that comes from it. So let me just give you a quick demonstration. So I'm gonna pop some eyeshadows here on my forehead. And I'm gonna give it, oh, that's come out strange. I'm gonna give it a spritz of a setting spray. Now, this is the Charlotte Tilbury one, the Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. And I'm just gonna give it a good, come on, good mist. Good mist of this product. Now I'm gonna let it set for about 2 minutes or so. And I'll see you back here. I think that's about 2 minutes. I hope so anyway. Okay, so basically now, if we do this, it's pretty good, right? That's pretty good. It doesn't move. That's the, well, most of it doesn't move. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now, that's the beauty of a setting spray. It can prolong and hold your makeup. Now here's the fun bit. Ready for a bit of oil? I'm gonna use one single drop, that's it, just that tiny, tiny drop, which you can't see, of oil. I'm gonna smooth it all over the hand first, so there's barely any on there. And then I'm gonna go over the makeup with it, right? And there you go. It instantly starts to dissolve and smear and smudge and become irritating. That's what happens to our skin. As our skin is pumping out oil all throughout the day, with oily skin tones, this is what happens. It just doesn't hold up. So the other pisser here, and this is a pisser, is that setting sprays often add shine to the face, right? Which is a peculiar thing. I think it's something to do with the polymers, that they have a shine to them. And even the ones that say that they're matte rarely are ever matte. And they all leave behind some form of finish to the skin that makes them shiny and just a little bit more dewy, I guess is the word for it. But of course, as the hours pass by with oily skin, it gets shinier and shinier and shinier, and then your face falls off because the setting spray doesn't work, because your oil is pumping out, your face is pumping out all this oil. So what can you do about it, right? Well, not much. To be honest, there isn't much you can do if you have very oily skin. And a setting spray is not a substitute for powdered touch-ups. And this is something that I really think people should be aware of. A compact and a sponge used throughout the day to powder one's face. Not only do I find it completely elegant and glamorous, it also is the number one tip or trick to keeping your makeup looking flawless all day long. Regular touch-ups are absolutely important, particularly for those of us with oily skin, because there's no way around it. There really isn't. Now, setting sprays can, as I mentioned, prolong the life of makeup, but with oily skin, they are not a substitute for powder touch-ups. However, you can do things like double loading, which will keep things in place much longer. And by double loading, what I mean is you use a setting spray as a primer first, then you apply your makeup, then you finish with a setting spray, and that can make a big difference. But oily skinned people, or those of you who find that your setting sprays are not working because of oil being pumped through your skin, you still need to touch up every single day. And that really is the big fat lie, is that there is this myth that setting sprays will hold your makeup all day long, and they really will, as long as you don't have oily skin. Because no matter what, as we saw in the demonstration, as soon as oil is applied to the skin, everything moves and fades and gets shiny and is a mess. Regular touch-ups throughout the day with powder will see you through. It's glamorous. It's old Hollywood. It's a beautiful thing to see a lady with a compact touching up her face. I really find it to be so glamorous. And also powder in general, a matte face tends to photograph more beautifully than an overly shiny one that we tend to see so much nowadays with dewy skin everywhere. But matte skin does photograph more beautifully. It minimizes the look of pores, and then you can apply the shine where you need it. And that's the myth. That's the big fat setting spray myth. They do work, but they don't really work very well for oily skin. They're not a substitute for powder touch-ups. Double loading can make a big difference to your routine. But if you're oily skinned, setting sprays, they're going to help, but they're not going to fix the problem. Thanks for watching, gorgeous creatures, and I will see you all very, very, very soon. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Oh, and all the links to all the products that I mentioned that actually set makeup, that really do set it, are in the description bar. Okay, I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.